A nationwide reading test turns up disturbing results for some Wisconsin students. Reading scores for African American students are the lowest of any other state, and the gap between black and white students is the worst in the nation. Kent Wainscott is in the newsroom with a look at what's being done to try to help close the gap.
You know, Toya, that achievement gap has been a statewide concern for some time, and typically the spotlight is focused directly on the state's biggest district, MPS. Well, we talked to the superintendent today who all but guaranteed that gap would decrease, and we visited one school that's trying to show how it's done.
Do what you say and say what you mean.
There is an achievement gap between black and white students at Milwaukee's 95th Street School, but in this school, the gap is narrowing. Reading scores here are up, and Principal Reginald Lawrence credits a focus on the individual student.
You may teach to a whole group or a whole grade level of children, but when you try and reach each individual student at their level, where they're at, and move them on, you know, that's where the important part comes.
The school, with an almost even racial mix, boasts reading scores that are above the district average at fourth grade and above the state average at third grade. Still, Lawrence worries about that achievement gap in his school and in schools across the state.
It says to me that Wisconsin has a lot of work to do for educating minority students.
The gap will keep narrowing. There's no question about that.
MPS Superintendent Dr. William Andrikopoulos is confident that achievement gap will grow smaller as more schools match the successes achieved at schools like this one.
If there's success at 95th Street, and there's success at in a large number of our schools, there needs to be a success in all of our schools.
What about if you're excited? Can you use an exclamation mark?
But while the success stories may be exciting for some schools, the state's largest and most diverse district has its work cut out in trying to narrow that achievement gap in all of its schools.
I know that we have more work to do, but at the same time, I know we're on the right plan.
Now, this is all based on results of testing done in the fourth and eighth grade, and overall, Wisconsin students did better than the national average in both reading and math. But again, the biggest concern for many folks are the low scores of minority students in Wisconsin and that achievement gap between white and African American students.
All right, Kent, thank you.